When we were kids, today was the future. Weren't we supposed to have flying cars by now? I suppose it's no surprise. The generation that promised them literally saw the horse-drawn carriage and man walk on the moon.
It's one small step for man.
We even went back to the moon with a car three times. Despite decades of promises, the flying car is still coming. The technology we have today is laying the groundwork to send your grandkids to school in the Skyway, even if their names aren't Judy and Elroy Jetson. As early as 1940, Henry Ford predicted a combination airplane and motor car. He famously said, "You may smile, but it will come." So why have we been wrong so far? A combination of physics, technology, and cost has kept the flying car from becoming a reality. Lifting a vehicle into the air as much as triples its weight, making fuel and distance an even bigger obstacle than cost, unless you're the military. The biggest issue Ford and others didn't see? Piloting a flying car. When you're stuck in traffic, you can't trust the guy in front of you with an X and a Y axis. He's got his left turn signal and permablink. Do you really want to give this jamoke a Z axis too? And that's why before we get a flying car, we need a self-driving car. Engineers at Google, Tesla, and Ford expect to have autonomous vehicles on the road as early as 2018, most likely 2021. The U.S. National Traffic Safety Administration has five levels of autonomy. Levels 1 through 3 take us from cruise control, automatic lane centering and braking, to taking your hands off the wheel on the highway. Level 4 is what we're all aiming for. You get into the car and it does all the work from the driveway to the destination. Level 5 is Johnny Cab.
Where can I take you tonight?
There's no steering wheel, no pedals. Uber is working with the auto industry on that as we speak. Once we figure out how to travel autonomously in two directions, well, the sky's the limit. In 2013, Terra Fugia announced a Level 5 fully autonomous flying car. The TFX has a 2025 target date for takeoff. If successful, the only hurdle to this flying car comes back to price. Ford's Model T was the first low-cost, mass-produced car. People had to take a leap of faith to spend $825 back then. That's the equivalent of $20,000 today. This flying car sells for $194,000. 8 times the price of the average car today. While waiting for the flying car, the world's biggest economy fell in love with the automobile. 7 in 10 Americans already own one, and there are more registered vehicles on U.S. roads today than people. So, we've solved the problem of physics. The technology is coming. All that's left is cost. So you can go back to telling the kids today, in the future, there'll be flying cars. For more on the technology behind the flying car, go to wheresmyjetpack.ca.